Thanks. This is a great episode. I know before doing it, and you should never say that, it puts pressure on their guests. And they have wonderful guests. They'll come in a second. But first, my quick rant is on, well, it's myself today. I realized that when you want something from somebody to do with money or favors, etc., we always start the sentence with a very funny opening, such as, I called our boss, Amit Doshi, who runs this whole thing. He's the pioneer here. And to discuss contracts and money and things like that. And I immediately said, Amit, do you have a minute? And I realized I never say that normally. I just start talking. So why do that then? People, when they want something from the other person, always say, do you have a minute? Yaar, ek do second ke liye baat kar sakta hai? Do you have time? You know, that kind of thing. So let's eliminate that, starting with myself. No more doing that. It's a very fake way and hypocritical way of getting to the point. Get to the point and just state your case. Two young men are going to state their case right now as we come to the end of this year. It's not yet fully over. You still have a week or so to improve your lives. We've got two young men who are going to become legends very soon. They're already doing really well. There's Gaurav Dagaonkar, and with him, his partner in crime is Sarthak Kalyani. I'm going to introduce them, and then we're going to chat about what they're doing. Lots to talk about, but basically, Gaurav, can you come? Can we look at you?
Gaurav, hey, hi, Cyrus. What's up?
Hi, Gaurav. Great to see you. And then there's Sarthak below. Another Indian thing. We say, great to see you. Don't wait for you to answer. I don't know why we do that. Kaise ho? Ho gaya. That's it. Nobody waits for the jawab. The jawab is not important. Sarthak, first, I'll come to you quickly. Your surname, I love it. Growing up, it was my favorite beer, Kalyani. I don't know if you guys, your generation, you have all the fancy brands and all that. But I remember Kalyani was a very strong beer, brother. Just like how your music is very strong. And this is a compliment. Please don't take any offense from it.
Yes, sir.
Gaurav, now we'll go back to, I've got biodata here, so please forgive me, I have to read it out. Otherwise, your representatives will come after us. And as you know, they are street fighters. Gaurav, you are the co-founder, I'm again telling you like you don't know, the co-founder and CEO of Songfest India, which is what we're going to talk about at length here. You're a music tech entrepreneur. I suppose that now, music tech, I mean, without being music tech, you can't be anything. The days of Mozart are long gone. So the tech has to marry the music talent.
I think they sent you the investor write-up because you know, there, if you don't write tech, nothing happens. There won't be a second meeting after that. So
no, but I'm sure, see, it's granted that both of you guys are super talented. There's no question about that. But I'm just trying to see what else is there because you're also entrepreneurs. See, that's the key here. It's not just the musician beta. There's more to it. You launched Songfest India in 2019. What is amazing, again, a waste of seats and for which you should be arrested by the police. An IT engineer, ladies and gentlemen, and I am Ahmedabad graduate. He's taking these seats while people are starving in this country, where he could have had 7 different jobs and then he went back to music, which is generally a fallback for a guy who's unpaid in the old days. You know what I mean? He's an artist there. So that's a shameful story, but it's true. So obviously overqualified and overeducated. As usual, God gives all the talent to people like you two. And the rest of us, 98% with our DNA, we have to manage whatever comes our way. So unfair life. Unconventional and exciting life. Dabbled in every sphere of the music industry. He didn't write this himself. With Songfest India, he and his team plan to offer cutting-edge viral solutions. We'll come to that. And promote popular artists, which is a huge, huge issue right now as the world is changing. Then partner in crime, Sarthak Kalyani. Sarthak has been a finalist on AR Arrived with AR Rehman. That's where he was basically discovered. And recently in Dubai, apparently he sang, please correct me if I'm wrong, 6 songs in 3 different languages for AR Rehman movies, movie 99 songs. Is this correct?
It's a mixed up information. Basically, I sang in a movie and I performed in a show, but like it's mixed up and it's like, okay, in Dubai I performed 6 shows. No, in Dubai I sang for AR Sir. In his ensemble, with his ensemble called Firdaus Orchestra, and his movie album called 99 Songs, I've sung 6 songs in 3 different languages, which were Tamil, Telugu, and Hindi. So,
wow. Okay, so it took us 15 minutes, but we cleared that point. So much for information from the net. Never get into that. Now let's talk a little bit about G Sharp Media before we go into the beginning and how you guys met and all that. Just tell us a little bit, either of you all, about G Sharp Media.
So G-Sharp Media is essentially our company, which is the music tech company. We've got 2 brands in it. One is Songfest. Songfest actually is a pure play content. We create music videos, music IPs, songs, right? And Sarthak has actually featured on one of the IPs we've recently created called Explore. So Songfest Explore. And we've just started working on a platform called Hooper, which is a music licensing marketplace. So that is the tech product part of G-Sharp Media. So yeah, we are a music company, essentially. A music.
One minute, stop. You stop the press here. Uber. So Hooper, when I call Hooper. My, how do you spell it?
H-O-O-P-R. Hooper.
Are yaar, enough cultures in India, the H will get swallowed. So I'll expect a taxi and you guys will come with a guitar. It might be embarrassing. I'm just telling you. I hope the rates are the same. It's ridiculous. Okay.
You might acquire more customers that way.
There you go. Music goes with everything. That's one safe point. Yeah. Okay, let's start at the beginning now about your association. Gaurav, I think you'll have to start off here. Sure. I think because without disrespecting you, you're the senior, apparently. So go ahead and tell us. How did you guys meet? What this whole platform is? Just give us a little idea, because I think growing up in the MTV days, we started with a big way with indie music. We had these Coca-Cola nights and all, you guys are familiar with all that, with the real talent I would say would come from. And then we got swallowed by Bollywood and the Bollywoodization, etc. And then, you know, it became like a mass produced thing. So please go ahead.
So our channel, Songfest, on YouTube just recently crossed 500,000 subscribers, and we realized that we've been talking about independent artists and upcoming talent, and we really haven't featured too many of them. So we decided to create this series called Explore. And so the way we got songs for it was, one, we opened up to artists saying that if you have an original song, just write into us and we'd love to create a video for you. One thing that really generally pisses me off in India is that labels today ask artists to create their own video. You know, khud paisa dalo, khud gana banao. And then, of course, there's marketing costs. So under the garb of empowering the artists, what they really mean is that, you know, you fund yourself, basically, and then we'll just put out. So we wanted to create an IP in which we produce the video we spend for marketing. The other way of getting songs was reaching out to artists who we quite liked. And Sarthak was one of them. So I had heard Sarthak's songs. The team had heard it. Heard his songs, and we reached out to a few such artists saying that if you have a song, reach out to us. So that's how we heard Sarthak's song Sahiba, and what blew us away is, of course, his singing ability, which, you know, we just heard during soundcheck. The song itself was very mature, and we started the series with Sarthak's song. So Sarthak's song Sahiba the is pioneer. The first of Sarthak pioneer is Sarthak ne start kiya, and hopefully this series becomes a platform where more, independent artists or younger artists come and get, a chance to show beautiful songs out there.
Is it, Gaurav, is it fair to say then that in India, no one has thought of the idea of promoting artists from their point of view, from your professional entrepreneur's point of view, where you promote them, give them a platform, and then, you know, everybody grows together. When you get a Sarthak, you know, to be honest, it's a commercial money spinner for you as well. Of course, there'll be 9 non-Sarthaks, but whatever, it all averages out at some point. So no one has thought of this idea of trying to promote, because what you're saying is correct. We just put on Instagram our so-called talents and, you know, hope the world will follow it.
That's right. See, if a label today signs an artist or creates a video for an artist, typically they would have then signed them for gigs and stuff, right? So there's a very clear way of earning back, or then there would be a brand that comes in. For us, we did not wait for any brand to come in. We've produced these 6 videos for season 1, purely with the intent of giving back and giving new talent a chance, right? We may get a brand going ahead as the series progresses, but as of now, it's pure play, and the other thing is, also spotting artists who have great songs irrespective of their fan following on an Instagram. So we also have artists who only have 14 followers on Instagram and so on. So it's not like, you know, iske 10,000 ya 1 lakh followers hai, so we've given him a break. It's because we are ourselves going to get promoted. So it's a very genuine,
I think that's a super point, Gaurav, straight off the bat. What a super point that to sound like a goody two shoes myself. But the fact that you guys are actually looking for talent, because I think it's so difficult in 21st century for people to not put all the facts collectively in, a commercial angle, this, that, influence, etc., etc., etc. Reach is so big for a lot of people. But what you're saying is that we just want to hear. We hear Sarthak. We don't give a damn if 9 people are listening to him. We can see that there's a gem there. We're going to take that gem and go forward with it. That's more power to you. That's fantastic. That's hope for people listening who have talent. Because there's actually an actual sincere platform for you now, thanks to Songfest India. And Sarthak is dying to talk. And he's more importantly dying to sing, and he's willing to sing. The test for the great artists is the ones that just like to perform. You can't stop them. You know, and the others will tell you, aaj nahi, aaj riyaz nahi kiya, and all that. You know, I won't take names, but I remember when we were interviewing back in the day, Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan came in the early days of MTV, and his nephew Rahat. and yeah. the other guys doing a sound check, Indian guys who were not willing to, you know, sing and all that, they were not warmed and all that. I won't take names, they're lovely guys. But this guy just started belting from the back of the auditorium without the mic. You know, Rahat, and it was like, what the hell is going on? And it sounded like Pavarotti, you know, this really powerful voice. And yeah. And Sarthak, the same thing crossed my mind when I was listening to offline before we started the show. Guys watching the show right now, he was quietly marrowing away with us, you know. I mean, the real genuine, you can't, I mean, if he was poor on the road, he's going to sing, you know. I for me, that's the real artist. If he's in a Chinese restaurant, if he's being felicitated by the United Nations, he's going to sing in every place because that's what he does. So, boss, that's beautiful. We get. Yeah, it was great to have you here. I love the fact that you guys are so passionate. So, Sarada, give us a little bit. Can we hear? What is it, Saiba? What do you want to give us? Give us anything you want. Let's get a taste of why Gaurav believes you are the next big thing.
So the thing I'll be performing today is just like a small section of the song. So the song is about love. And we know so many poets, so many like people, composers.
It's easier to go the other way. How many didn't talk about love? We can make a smaller list. Right. Yeah.
Right. So, yeah. So, it's easier the other way. So, yeah, this is my way of actually trying this out. And so, I have included two of the most extreme feelings which are in love. One is when we are very much deep in the love, wherein we are very emotional. We are very, you know, patient, and we are very happy. We feel very satisfied. And then there's this other feeling, which is very complex, you know, when we are impatient, we reach out to someone and they aren't there. And then we are like, oh shit, where are they? Oh, and we get impatient. We are in a hurry. Just pick up my call, something like that, maybe. So that is that another extreme feeling of love. And I have tried to blend these two feelings along with the lyrics of my good friend Satyan Srajat, who portrayed the good story of Mirza and Sahiba through his lyrics. And today I'm just performing one section of that song. I'm not performing the whole song, but you should go check it out. And yeah, I hope you like it.
Please go ahead.
Am I audible? Keys? तू खामखा क्यों बिसरी जबा हो जैसे मिसरी चूहे तो फिर पानी में भी है आग लगा दी क्या रे मिर्ज़ा क्या पुकारे इन दोनों के बिना रे ना होगी पूरी अधूरी सी कैसी है ये रवानी बेखबर सी ये आंखें एक जा है और सांस तू बन किनारा सारा ये हवाएं भी तेरी दीवार कैसी ये अदा है जाने सा एक नाम बस साहेबा साहेबा मैं मलंग रंग तू साथ साथ तू राही मैं तेरी छांव तू आब मैं बहता राग तू गीत मैं तेरा सांस एक नाम बस साहेबा साहेबा
Wow.
Thank you.
That's exactly. Memories of Nusrat and family come back to me immediately simply because, you know, I just hear the voice and you can see, you know, without being arrogant, just the artist doing his thing. There's a difference when you're trying to show off and all that. I've seen that as well, but this is lovely to hear. And I immediately got that memory recall immediately of them, just testing their voices. Just not bothered about who's there or not there. Just professional.
I have always been such a big fan of Nusrat Saab. Like, since I was young, I used to listen to him a lot. Like, his 30-hour concerts, I used to attend like so many times on YouTube. And it's such a big thing that you compared me to him. And
absolutely the same. You come from the same family of the culturally, you're very similar. You can see that immediately that you just want to sing. I think that's so important. Like, a fast bowler should bowl, a warrior should go to battle, and a singer should sing. Then we have these type of singers who are always unconfident. Yaar, I don't want to get into the whole studio and tech support that they need or whatever. They don't want to sing. And you're wondering, it's like your comedian comes and then he says, "Aaj to joke tay kar sakta yaar. Aaj to Sunday." It's pointless. Yeah, so that's great. Hope that stays.
One thing I'd just like to add here, Sahir, is that Sarthak is also one of those composers who has a fantastic understanding of sound. So if you listen to the recording, it's very, very, I would say, different from the composition. It has beautiful Western elements, and that juxtaposition is very beautiful to hear. So he's worked very hard on that song, and hence we started with this one. Great stuff, Sarthak. We totally believe in you, and I think you're destined for something.
Basically, I am a singer-songwriter, and I write independent music as an independent artist, and I release one song every month. And along with that, I also sing, produce, arrange, program music for other composers out there. And I not just only sing songs, but I also like write for scores for short films, TV series, and etc.
So, one second. So, when you do that, who has the credit? The composer gives you the credit, or they just swallow it?
No. So when we program for others, basically the idea is there. So, they give us credits as programmers or as additional programming or something like that. So usually what happens, like, if some composer has an idea, okay, this is the kind of thing which I need. So what they'll give it out to programmer. So if we have a drawing, you would have done that drawing, no? Like, as a kid, wherein you fill in the color book, colors in the color book. It's similar to that. He'll give you a structure and then you'll just need to fill in the colors. So that is called programming, basically.
Collaborative effort. It becomes from his side, quietly. I understand. So your book will reveal everything. Don't worry. But also, Gaurav is fluent in what, four languages of the South, as well as Hindi, obviously, English, obviously. So he can sing in all these. I mean, the confidence to sing, I was just thinking also, it's not that easy to switch. I know Usho Autop can do it so easily about 10 or 12, including Swahili and German and all that. So that's another talent altogether, to have the ear to pick up the lyrics.
I'm really sorry to interrupt, but I'm not fluent in these languages. But the thing is, I learn them by sound and not by... whatever language you give it to me, I learn them by meaning and sound. So I just remember the lyrics, but I'm not very fluent in speaking these.
Please don't be modest. Nobody wants you to become a telemarketer in 7 languages across India. That's not the point. The point is, it's another talent to be able to do that easily. Yes, whatever you give a, I mean, this is the Indian culture and your ear is used to it. But I'm sure if I give you Polish, you will, with a little practice, your ear will pick it up. And that is another ability altogether.
Yeah. So I've also sung in Marathi, Bengali, and in Malayalam also I've sung a song. So...
But do you know the bad words in all these languages? I mean, kuch to sikhna padega na isme. What's the point of picking up only lyrics? You must always tell the composer.
You're from Bangalore, right, Sarthak? Chennai.
I'm from Indore.
You're from Indore.
Yes. And since last 3 years...
He's from Hindi-speaking belt. And then he speaks all South languages in terms of music, at least. Bengali, which is also tough in its own way. Marathi. I'm sure what is left? Yeah, you can do Malayalam.
Malayalam. Kannada also I've sung. So I sung in all these languages, but like I understand them little bit. So
here's the advantage for you, sir. Whichever state you're in, the rickshaw driver gives you trouble, you just start singing in that language, and immediately, boom, everything's taken care of. Yes. That's a power. That's a great power. Okay, Gaurav, let's get back to the slightly more serious topics. I suppose we've covered the motive to launch a platform like Songfest. There's no need to really go into that. But how is Songfest Explore different from any other IP that supports independent music creators? I asked you that. There must be something out there. It's a difficult question, I suppose, to answer, because everybody wants different. But different kya hai? And is that necessary?
The most basic difference is kharcha hum log kar rahe hain. So I think these days, that is a big factor. And we, so Sarthak, say for example, is still, I would say, an established name. Sarthak has sung quite a few songs and has featured in other series. But you won't believe it, Cyrus. There are 3 out of the 6 guys, this is the first time they've ever faced the camera. there's a band from Yavatmal, right? And this guy had come to Bombay after we had put out the Explore, you know, call to action. He came and met us, and his entire band came to Bombay from Yavatmal. This is the first time. So they were super scared. They were very scared. And we had to literally, you know, because the song is so beautiful. So I think in that sense, there's been a bit of mentorship from our entire team, you know, in terms of how to tell the story of your song, how to perform bites. We've done radio tie-ups, so also how to, you know, speak to the RJs. So we had a small REM session, as we call it, in the studio, where we told them, ki yaar, aisa hota hai, load mat lo, great songs. So I feel proud that, you know, we've done that. That's perhaps the difference in this, I think.
Also, what you've done, most important is give hope. I would say, if a young musician, suppose I'm somewhere in Jabalpur, a young musician trying to understand the world, very sincere about my talent. I know that if I can get my, if I get Songfest to, you know, hear me once, or, you know, meet the guys, or they get to understand who I am, there's a chance that I can really go places. Which sometimes, if you're a struggling musician who doesn't come from the big 4 or 5 metros, it must be really hard. You come to Lokanwala in Bombay and try to meet music. You've heard these stories. They're really cruel and sad.
They're very cruel. I agree.
So I think that window is huge. This is good karma, Gaurav. Very good karma, if nothing else.
There's one more big factor which they have done, and I really appreciate it, is not telling artists what to do, because they never told me that Sarthak, your song
not yet,
be...
Sarthak, not yet.
Not yet. Yeah, they never told me that Sarthak, your song cannot be 5 minutes, because my song is 5 minutes.
No, I'm not worried about that. I'm worried that UP ka election chalu hai, fir Sarthak ko bulao, fir kya karega stage pe? Then Gaurav is not pulling the strings. You call Gaurav, his phone will be off. Yeah, be careful. So, there are other things.
No, but as a musician, I think the most liberty you can give to an artist is like in his music, because I know what I'm doing, and for first 30 seconds in my song there's a riff running and only chorus sections happening. And if I would have played it to any other person, he would have been, yeah, Spotify pay, there's a 30 second ka thing and it's not satisfying that, I'm really sorry,
pass
that
the buck.
Song cannot go ahead. But when I played it to them, they were like, okay, let us hear the full song, and they liked it, and they were like, okay, let's build the video around what audio you have produced. And yeah, they took it ahead from that. So I really appreciate that. And I think all over India, this thing should happen, wherein like some pieces of, like, just not stick to reels and things, but actually come out of that and listen to real music, wherein the pieces can be half an hour long if they need to.
You're right. You have to give time. I mean, how will you judge the quality of an artist just by one or two notes? I mean, you can see something there, but you have to give them time. And I feel that we are guilty. By we, Sarthak, well before you were born, there was a music channel called MTV, another one called Channel V. We started this sort of revolution where independent music, or whatever you want to call it, in the music, in different languages, but just people with their own outside the film world kind of representation. We initially went very big with that. We did rock shows, we did pop shows, whatever you want to call it, North, South, Calcutta, everywhere we went. And a lot of people were encouraged by that, and suddenly we just turned and said, "Ye to nahi chalega, nahi ho paega, let's move on." And that's it. We gave up too quickly, because so much talent in the country now, with Indian Idol and all these things slowly showing us what talent is around North, South, East, West. And that's where Gaurav comes in a big way, because he realizes actually he's going to win at the end of the day. He's not going to lose. And I feel bad that we gave up so quickly, and our, you know, because they're all looking at the ledger book and thinking, "Do saal ke baad we've not progressed," or whatever. But this is a whole culture which is growing. And one day when Gaurav is driving his fancy Porsche worth 2 crores and, you know, to his helicopter launch pad to go to Lonavala for the farmhouse on his way to London for a meeting, you'll know that it's because he backed people like you, you know, because they just need one or two Sarthaks for the whole thing to go through the roof, which is what's going to happen, touch wood. Sorry for my long lectures as an old man, and no one listens to me, so I thought I'd catch two of you, I'll keep talking. Let's talk about...
These are funny.
Sarthak is going to Google me afterwards. He's going to tell his dad, "I met somebody your age." Really, a pain in the ass here. Let's go through the process.
I came for this. I came to listen to all this. It's funny.
What
I love it.
Here. Today, anyone can be an anchor. It's amazing. I'm so sorry. The process of recording the tracks and helping the artists, I have very formal questions the PR company has sent. I don't want to upset them, whatever happens. And Sarthak, anytime you want to sing, you sing. Okay, we'll stop talking in the middle. So if you feel for whatever reason, please, yeah, as much as we can hear of you. But Gaurav, going back to the whole process of recording, what is the process? How does one become a part of the Songfest revolution?
So at least for Explore, the good part is we received about 250 songs, out of which about 150 of them are quite well produced. So what we realize is that today people, you know, youngsters have this, you know, MacBook and a GarageBand, Logic Pro, So production actually has become really big. I remember when I, you know, long back when I wanted to make an album, I went to meet Ranjit Barrett and he had this big studio and I felt that, okay, now I think there'll be some semblance of a good production. But today, I think youngsters don't need that. They're producing great music from their homes. I think Sarthak, maybe y'all also would have collaborated out of your home studio and then went to record
the vocals. I have done all of my songs through this, but also I work in ARR studios. So I think that's the best studios in India. So I have seen the best also. And this, I think it's easily workable through this because nowadays the technology has become so good and so cheap compared to previous times, because previously mics used to come for like some 1 lakh rupees and I don't think anyone could have afforded. Now they're very cheap. They start from 5,000 rupees and you can afford them and you can have a proper home studio. Plus, you realize that last year, Billie Eilish and his brother, even they had a home studio from which they won some 10 Grammys. That's a big thing. So,
really?
Nowadays, yeah.
Correct. They produce their album from home.
Billie Eilish and Phineas, they have a proper home setup. I know their setup is really costly, but mostly what they use is properly Logic, which I'm also using, and the mic. And some few instruments, but the thing is, nowadays you don't need the big orchestras. You need them, of course you need them, but you can easily create mock-ups, orchestral mock-ups and things, which are good enough. If you actually work on them, they sound like a real orchestra, but you have to spend so much time, like 9 hours, 10 hours, just like seeing each and every articulation here and there.
But the thing is, you can at least start. You know, you can start. There's no need to wait for these.
I'm saying something else.
That's
you can start, but you can also finish there. You don't need anything else. I'm saying
that. Of course.
Whatever I'm producing, just check the quality. Just check everything. The mastering levels. Everything is to the point. It's to the industry level, and from home you can do that. You don't need a proper, very costly setup nowadays. What you need is a very good computer and a MIDI and a microphone, you are done. And of course, a sound card. And you are done. You don't need very heavy equipments, very costly equipments.
Gaurav, I think Sardar ka kehne ka matlab kya hai, isme andar ki baat kya hai, I have understood, please correct me if I'm wrong, is that this Billie Eilish character, to Marwadi hai, basically. Okay, and it had to have some desi touch to it. And that's why they thought ki curse kaisa save kar sakta hai. And from that point of view, you marry the talent with the Indian desi thinking and boom, you got this. And what, 8 Grammys from the basement. I'm thinking, what about the solid use about the Chutia musician who sold his house and his kidneys to produce some mind-numbing, fantastic electronic sound, but he doesn't win the Grammy. These guys are sitting at home or eating fish and chips and having pint of beer or whatever it is. And, wow, what a story.
That's not a necessity nowadays, and it's totally in the box. In the box means in the computer. You can have everything in the computer. So
let's face it. I mean, the end users listening to their song often on the speaker of this thing. Yeah. So you know, those Fadu mastering karenge and this guy. Finally, people are going to listen to it on TikTok or some other app.
But you can do that in the system itself. That's what I'm saying.
You can.
Yeah, you can. So nowadays, the technology is really brilliant and you can do everything in the box. So you don't actually need heavy things. And I'm not saying it's a show off. It's a need for somebody who needs it. But yeah, you can have a small setup and still win Grammys because so many people are doing that.
No, so there are two issues. One, Sarthak, what you're saying, ki ho sakta, kar sakta, fair enough. And not even with great technology, with just simple phones and, you know, you can work on all kinds of apps and also possible. But the second thing, sorry, you will interrupt me. But no, please do this.
Basics, no, we need to be very clear about the basics. Our mic needs to be good because once the recording is done, we cannot do anything about with the quality of it. We can, if it's 19, we can make it 20. If it's 10, I cannot make it 20.
Okay, so I'll correct myself. It cannot just be the phone, but I'm saying at least that's a starting point for them, and then they can invest in the mic or whatever and the slightly better technology. But the second part is where Gaurav comes in, or you come in also now, is that talent has to be seen, or how do you reach out and find that talent? And that's where your entire business, the Songfest India, that's the more important side for me. Y'all going and finding these guys that now have a chance to show wherever, however, whether it's Insta or some local party or whatever. And then Gaurav comes in and you guys come in and then you hone the talent, which is I think let's see the next 5 to 10 years where India can go, because I really believe the kind of talent we have, it's been contained in what, 3-4 cities and 5-6 families. And, you know, it's really, it's once it explodes, it's like cricket now. Mumbai is struggling to win any match. where we were the kings of cricket for 60 years. Okay, all the talent is coming from elsewhere. It's amazing. Gaurav, current projects is Songfest and future projects. Let's get into that.
So we are working. We did an IP last year called Double Mint Fresh Take. So this was a cool IP in which we took a theme, say, you know, friendship, and created a video that had a fresh take on the theme itself. We also created fresh takes of every Hindi song in regional languages. So the IP did well. We got millions of views, a few awards and so on. So we are creating season two for Fresh Take. And this time, thankfully, hopefully, you know, COVID is sort of behind us, and we might also have, hopefully, touch wood. So we might do Fresh Take.
Bada parivar hai. There are many kids.
I know. But apart from that, you know, COVID also made us do ads, which we actually had never planned to do. But it was that point where, you know, any business had to sort of take on any project to survive. So we started doing ads, and a couple of our ads actually went viral last year. We did this ad for Magic Pin, which was a spoof on Cred. And we took Vijay Raz and we did a very funny ad, which was a spoof on the Rahul Dravid Cred ad. So,
which is a spoof? You did a spoof on a spoof?
we did a spoof on a spoof. And that one went viral. And since then, we've been getting ad work. So we are wondering what to do with it because it's coming. And it, while, you know, we are Songfest. So right now, we are at that crossroads where we have to either spin off an ad division or then figure out what to do.
Why not? It comes from the same family. Yeah. It's a creative family. You're going from song. You're still involved in song in some way also. And that makes a lot of sense.
True.
Yeah.
True. Absolutely.
Before we go to a break and we quickly get Silvery on, Sarthak, shall we hear something else? What do you want to bajao for us?
Yeah.
Okay.
And Gaurav, feel free to join in.
Okay. I'll do something separately because with this lag, online many things, I'll have a 2 second echo come. It'll be like an echo effect.
Give me half a minute.
So you got to say the words that will keep the audience enthralled. Check. 1, 2, check. Everyone has that accent when doing the check. Yeah, check it. Come, check.
I'm saying the metal singers are even more entertaining when they do their
job.
All of those.
I had an experience of a singer once who did exactly what you said, and then when he sang the song, his voice was lighter than Lata at her youngest. It's a very high pitch. So he went from chalk to hey. It was like such a, we all laughed like that. Haji sir.
Yeah.
So, as I said, every month I release one original, and this one is from a. From my band in which I'm collaborating with another music producer and a music supervisor. So this is a proper ghazal which was written long back, and we composed this and we created the music around this. But the music is actually very different from what I'm going to sing today because it's a lo-fi thing and this is proper unplugged. So yeah. Is the guitar audible properly?
Very.
Rang duniya mein kai aur bhi और भी है बहके से हजारों के सिवा जी सके हम ना सहारों के सिवा शामिल और सितारों के सिवा शाम-ए-गम और सितारों के सिवा जी सके हम ना सहारों के सिवा।
Fantastic, yeah. In Western music, I think it's called the libretto, that voice quiver, that, you know, that lovely. Chicks must, you must, with girls, you're doing really well, Sarthak. Hey, Gaurav, he's not answering the question. Please use your pull.
Yes. Huh? Sarthak, I'm saying female attention, kaisa chal raha life mein? I'm sure.
Translate karne ka koi zarurat bhi nahi hai. He's understood the question, he's still not answering it. don't worry, Kalyani Saab, we're just teasing you. But Gaurav, I'll give you a minute to prepare. Let's hear you as well.
This guy is pitch perfect, huh, Sarthak. Because I've heard Sahiba, you just, both your songs here, pitch perfect singing.
Thank you.
Wow. He's fantastic. Honestly, like I said, I just like the fact that he's a singer. You just wake him up and he'll sing for you. Gaurav, you ready to go? We'll give you a minute. We'll get Silvery in also, if you want to put anything together. Silvery, come in as we go into break. The artist known as Antariksh, Silvery. I don't know if he's a good singer. Silvery, can you sing? Please don't sing now after Sarthak, but I'm just asking. Also, mute is the problem. We can't hear what you're saying.
I can hold a tune quite well, I feel. But I'm not.
After listening to him and now Gaurav, you be very careful.
I can hold a tune. I'm very confident in holding a good tune. The rhythm is fine.
So once Gaurav finishes, we'll make them, one of them has to
Please, I'm not singing.
Even two lines. There's no way
I'm singing on the same episode that two professional singers are on. There is no way.
Fair enough.
Antariksh, you just said that hold that note. Cyrus, sometime back I saw a video of yours where you were wishing someone and you said, I love the way I held that note. Note is what I did this.
No, but I've heard during plays that we've done in my childhood, I've heard professional singers, of course, in English plays, but they're decent voices and all, actually telling the sound guy, you see how I held that note? You know, if you detach the conversation between musician and techno person, you know, sometimes it just sounds ridiculous, yeah, just the conversation. So many reverb stories, you guys have no idea how my generation musician went mad about the reverb. But anyway, Gaurav, when you're ready, let's hear something. Come on.
Okay, I'll sing this recreation that I did for an old classic, and a lot of people liked it, so I'll just sing this one. Dekhta raha, pata hi na chala, waqt kaun si gali nikal gaya, samne raho, to yun lage hume. दिल हमारा हमसे कोई चाल चल गया तड़प रहे हैं प्यार में ना यूं सताइए बेकरार करके हमें यूं ना जाइए आपको हमारी कसम लौट आइए बेकरार करके हमें यूं ना जाइए आपको हमारी कसम लौट आइए.
Woo! Must have been growing up in the IIT days and all, IIM days and all that. I'm just thinking, you must have been more like a rocker. What was that like from a musical point of view?
I used to sing a lot of these Pearl Jam songs back then. Pearl Jam. And also a bit of pop. So all the way, let's say from Bon Jovi, Pearl Jam, Bryan Adams, all of those songs. And then later, of course, gradually I started adding Kishore Kumar when I realized nobody was clapping. at least the girls were leaving the moment those songs started. so then started adding a bit of Euphoria and you know, some of these Hindi songs. But yeah, mainly grew up, the 90s actually was a very healthy period for indie pop. We had some lovely acts like Lucky Ali, Silk Route, Junoon, you know. So those were the kind of songs that I used to listen to along with the English songs that I had.
Yeah, Junoon, the Pakistani band that came around, they were great. Yeah, and there's a guy called Ali Haider. I don't know if you remember.
Also, Vikas Khanna's restaurant, Junoon.
Ali Haider, yeah. Purani Jeans, right? Purani Jeans.
Or guitar. Yeah, fantastic. Sorry, Sardak, well before your time, beta. You will not remember.
No, I've heard all of this.
Damn it. It is too good.
I used to be a big fan of Mohammed Rafi, Kishore Kumar, everyone.
Oh, so, huge.
In fact, the other day, somebody asked me, you know, we were discussing about singers who have an unusual tone and there was nobody before them or after them. And one of these singers was Neeraj Sridhar, who came in the 90s with Bombay
Yes,
Vikings.
Yes, right? Bombay Vikings. Kings.
Yeah.
Wo chali, that one. He used to remaster those, yeah.
Yes, yeah, and nobody can sound like him. I mean, he had a unique voice. He sang some Hindi songs also, right? All those.
All Kishore Kumar takeoffs mostly, as far as I remember, yeah.
Yeah, but he had that unique, he came from Sweden also, I think, briefly. Yeah, so he got that great sense of harmonies and pop.
Like I said, those were the days we were encouraging all these guys, and that whole thing was booming. And then it, you know, so now God, if you're the rebound,
you all did a great MTV, you know, all that Select and so many shows were.
Yeah, we enjoyed all that, you know, promoting all this ingrown talent, and all was so much fun to discover them. Yeah. That's why talking to Sarthak again, I'm feeling like that again, you know, because you're seeing them in the raw, you're seeing them now at the start, and then God knows where they'll reach, etc., etc. But the baton is with you, Gaurav. I think we have to go into the AMAs now. As we reach the end of this horrible show of ours, let's see what we've got lined up.
Sure.
Mr. Silvery, yes.
Yes. This first one, the first AMA question comes in from Darshan Johar. He says, "Hey, Cyrus and dear guests, we often hear about actors as actors. I've always wondered, is there such a thing as singers as singers? And who would you say should be on that list? Perhaps someone who doesn't get the praise and accolades they should be getting. Your thoughts."
So this is what we've been discussing from the beginning. I presume ki the real singer versus the, let's call it manufactured. Gaurav, you're the guy for this year. But we obviously won't take the names of the guys who are manufactured. But
No, I think, look, we live in a world where the manufactured talent is going to be there and there's no running away from it. I mean, you know, K-pop actually has so many bands that are, you know, worked upon since they're 15, 16 years old. And having said that, there are also artists like Sarthak who are naturally phenomenal singers. So, right. And I think people like us who are running, say, a channel or a label.
There was no one in my family who used to sing, and I have been learning Indian classical since last 15
years. No, but what the point is that, you know, you are gifted at it, right? You are a good singer, and there's no doubt about it. And at the same time, sometimes look from somebody who works with a label or a channel, you also need people who are perhaps, you know, great performers or maybe are able to generate a fan following and you know, get the views. That X factor is there. So I think, quite honestly, we have to adjust. We're going in that space where it's going to be a necessary evil and you can't run away from it. Otherwise, we'll be in an idealistic world and kid ourselves. But just like the way OTT has opened doors for so many great actors to come back and, you know, perform, I think because of YouTube, Spotify, and a lot of new age labels coming in, a lot of good artists, singers are back and they're doing what they should.
Yeah, and I keep telling people, if you don't like the music, you don't listen to it. It's just as it is with the comedian or with the art form or whatever. Yeah. Why do people overdo it? You don't like it, it's subjective. Go to the next. It's not a personal thing. People are all, hey, why is he so famous? Why do we get jalaud like that, you know, as human beings sometimes with the so-called success of the other person, that jalaud feeling. I know it's an internal issue with your psychiatrist, as you have to talk to your own personal frustrations you take out on some famous person. Well, they've not done anything wrong. They also struggled and tried to come up and they were lucky, maybe, whatever, that's it.
Yeah.
Silvery, you become...
In fact, you're right. It's so much better now, because earlier when there was only broadcast, I remember we had the Super in Mukabla and whatever was 10, 9, 8, 7, you had to listen to it. There wasn't any skip button. Today you have the power. You don't like something, don't listen to it.
Yeah, really, radio has also changed. Sarthak, in our time, there was a thing called radio, a chota transistor, aisa tha, with the aerial, and we used to listen to music, and we had to wait, like he said, we had to wait for the songs till the one you liked. There's no fast forward, rewind, no change or whatever. It was quite painful, you're right.
Yeah.
But life has changed. Silvery ji, next one.
Yes. I have a question, like, so similar to what was just asked by Darshan. Like, do you guys? So we, I know, like, I'm a comedian. Saris is a comedian. We know there are comedians who we look up to and we admire all our life. Basically, comedians who made us want to be comedians. Did you have musicians like that who made you want to sing and be musicians?
Okay, this is a separate answer okay. Because,
Actually, so many.
Yeah.
So as a kid, I used to so like Shankar Mahadevan sir, and I used to love that how he used to use his voice in all the Breathless. Genres. Yeah, so Shakti, the band, if you have heard them, crazy band. And from there to proper jazz, to proper Bollywood romantic, to proper Carnatic classical, to proper Indian classical, he just
right.
kills all of it. He's like, he's the master of it. And plus, even he brought some very new concepts into markets, which is like Breathless. So he was my idol as
lovely a guy. Sarthak, have you met him? Really nice guy.
I met him, but
I'm sure you will one day. You love him. He's one of those guys who everybody likes. He's just one of everybody likes guy. Yeah.
Yes. So after him, as I grew up, I started listening to ARR music, and that was another new world opened up to me, because he was again doing so many genres together. He was doing proper classical music and combining it with like electro music, and each of his albums was like such a fresh take on each and everything. Even classical bandishes, which I used to learn in classical, I'm like, oh, this guy has used it like this. Oh, it's so interesting. It's so new. It's so fresh. So he was the man. And then recently I came in touch with new music from Jacob Collier, if you know him. Then so this guy, he combines all full Western theory with proper different genres basically, and he just kills his music, and the way he performs, the way he interacts with the audience, he makes him sing, and he uses so many different elements, his voice, and he's a multi-instrumentalist. He plays so many instruments. And that too, when he performs live, it's crazy. So I think these are three biggest artists who have been like my idols. And I really look up to them.
Okay. Silvery didn't mention you or me. Damn it. Gaurav?
Well.
I think Sarthak is a good boy. He's a, you know, he's the musical. I would say thoda. Sarthak is a nerd and listens to good music and doesn't say anything beyond that. I think to make people happy, which is good. I like that about him.
What about you? What are your inspirations? I mean, you're a full-fledged musician. I mean, this is not just one side to you.
I would say, again, yeah, quite a few. I think I love Vishal Shekhar's music. I think at least when I started doing films, the fact that most of their songs have been original and quite versatile. Across different genres, so I love their songs. I also really love KK. I think he's one of those great guys, and I've recorded 3-4 songs with him. And I think he's a very chill guy who, once the recording gets done, there's no music that's spoken. It's all
and possibly the number one event performer. Huh? I mean, has so much work; it's ridiculous. Huh?
Yes, and again, he's one guy who everyone likes because there's absolutely no, you know, showbazzy. He's so much Nothing. Fun. So these are two guys who I really like, and I think Arijit is also good. I recorded a song with him and it was super fun. He is so musical, and again, he's one of those guys you've imagined a song in a certain way, he comes and brings it alive exactly the way or even better than what you've thought. So and quite a grounded and a humble person, so these are good guys to work.
And then you had your rock side, the Western side, which is the, as you mentioned, Pearl Jam, etc. and all that.
Yeah, so that essentially, I joined this engineering college in Bombay, Thadomal, in Bandra, because I felt that...
Are they world famous?
Yeah. So, you know, there were good bands there. And I think it was the only engineering college in Bombay. So, I used to miss the IIT classes and go and bunk and watch movies. And my dream college was Thadomal, because I thought it was a good crowd and so on. And got into music because of Thadumal. So there were these various rock pockets, right? Somebody used to listen to heavy stuff like Black Sabbath, Sepultura, and all those metal bands. And then there were the Pink Floyd guys who considered themselves wiser than everyone else. And then there were these, you know, punk and grunge guys like Pearl Jam, Nirvana, and all those people. So they all happened to be in my class. So I sort of gravitated there and became friends with them.
Okay,
then
another racist.
To the Pink Floyd stage.
But you know, another racist theory of mine is that when I talk to guys like you, how Indians are, I hate to use the word superior, but in a way we are, because nobody has the kind of collective consciousness of art that we can get, because we are really open to everything in that sense. And you, yeah. Both you and Sarthak, I mean, you can start from Hindustani classical, go to Western classical and everything in between. I mean, look at A.R. Rahman for exactly what he mentioned there. And I think with no disrespect to other nations and cultures, they don't have that bandwidth. But we have that bandwidth, and it's just part of who we are. Nobody, you know, it's just there, completely there.
It's there.
And I think whether you like it or not, you all are influenced by all these things.
That's true. I think because at one level, you know, we have our own native languages, and the other thing is also English speaking is pretty good in this country. So what happens is you start, once you reach that stage where you start understanding lyrics and stuff, so you sort of realize how much music the West also has to offer. And then, you know, if you've learned Indian classical, then it's great fun after that. Then you can actually...
Indian classical, it's like the base of everything. So if you actually learn that, your ear training is so good that if you listen to ear training plus your rhythm too, because there's some kind of music in Brazil, or if you have ever listened to people like Sergio Mendes or people like that, it's crazy. The Cuban music, Latin music, it's crazy. The rhythms are crazy. And... plus the harmony and everything, that is not very strong in India yet, but it's growing, and we are melodically very strong, and ear-wise we are super strong. So it doesn't take a lot of time for us to get that harmonic thing. So yeah, I think Indian classical, once you learn, you can actually kill any genre.
But Sarthak, I hope you've understood Gaurav's message. He's given a message a little earlier. If you watch this program, a recorded version later, you'll realize what I'm saying. He clearly pointed out that he had to switch genres for the ladies. The necessity is a very important thing here. And that was very important. So it's not what he did like. Sometimes it's not what you like. It's what the ladies like. So you pick up that also. So depending on where you are and who you're talking to, what age group, what culture, subculture, wo bhi wo paristhiti dekhe, you have to look at the thing and then you decide what to sing. Which the Indian talent like you and Gaurav can do. I'm saying, if I put you in France or I put you in, as you mentioned, Brazil, you'll still be able to figure it out. That's the wonderful thing about Indian talent. That's fabulous, really. Okay, I'm interrupting AMA flow. Silvery.
Next one comes in from Heeral Singhal. She says, "Hi, Cyrus and guests. Hope you're doing well. This might be a weird question, so expecting your weird answers. If you had the option to commit one crime without ever getting caught for it, what would you do?"
Now we are going away from music. Unless you want to talk about piracy. Sarthak, would you like to go? One crime.
I'm not sure. Please, Gaurav, please answer. I'll think about it.
Cyrus, you start. You can inspire us. I would like to
rob something that irritates me the most. Are these, what are they called? The mask guys? The mask marshals. You know, those kind of outfits. I want to infiltrate them. And I want to rob them.
You'll make great money.
Yeah, I want to loot the looters. Yeah, I want to just take that money out. And I always want to know when these vans pass.
Maybe Gaurav and Sarthak don't have context. You think they just want to rob innocent people?
the marshal valas.
Marshals have been extorting people. This came out of the pay. Yeah. Mumbai police marshals, basically, they're not police, but they're marshals who stop people if they're not wearing masks. And they've been basically extorting people. They cover that body language of the phone, kind of thing,
make you feel guilty and then demand the money. And now there's this whole issue about how they've just been pocketing the cash and not giving receipts, etc., etc. So those kind of people, I'm a bit like Robin Hood. I want to rob a lot of people. But and in our country, there are plenty of people who should be robbed without taking big names, including political party offices. Lots of money there, especially elections around the corner in four states. Sorry to take you all away from the world of music, but please go ahead and humor us. What crime will you do?
So it would have to be money-based, right? Like, I would say robbing Elon Musk of all his money would be great. You know, like Jeff Bezos. Just get all of Jeff's money. You can never get caught
for it. Their wives have done that. Their wives, at least Jeff Bezos' wives already cleaned him out. Yeah.
Yeah. So Rob is wife then. Yeah, whatever. Either way works.
That's why they created blockchain, right? So something can happen tomorrow. Nobody.
No, look at the karma there. I mean, it's perverse. She divorces him, takes 50% or whatever, and then puts all the money in charities. I'm thinking, what? Yeah, yeah, yeah. What the hell?
That's taunting him. That's like taunting him. Look what I do with your money.
Yeah. I think I'd love to express my opinions on a lot of political people. Sadly, ever since I started running this business, each time I wanted to do it a lot more than anything, Mandal. You know, so yeah, yeah, yeah. I think somewhere I, you know, we all hold ourselves back, or at least I do. And, you know, I wish I could just say a lot of things.
Now you've reached the Premchand status, because your point is satire. Again, like you spoofed a spoof. Wow. It's satire on another level. What you said is, I would like to have freedom of expression and speech, which is a crime in India, in a sense. That's what you have conveyed to us right now. Yeah. So very elegantly done. Sophisticated thought. Superb. Superb. Young. Yeah. Sarthak?
I might name Apple like to myself. So, yeah.
You want to own Apple?
Own Apple.
Yeah.
Wow.
I'm such a huge Steve Jobs fan. Such a huge Steve Jobs fan. And also, like, I'm an engineer. So, I'm completing like fourth year of triple IT. I dropped out in the middle, but I rejoined the college. And so I'm also like a proper IT person. So,
hey, so sweet. Simply get that. Dying for 1 hour on the program, dying to point out your Gaurav again. I'm also IT guy and all that. Okay. All right, brother. Yeah, like, both of you all are blessed with lots of talent. And give back now. Don't worry. Yeah. You all have more than enough surplus. Sorry. Now, one more. One or two more if you can.
Okay. So this last one comes in from Yoshita K. Mukhopadhyay. She says, hey, everyone. Big fan of the podcast. Been a listener for years now. My question is... Often, talentless people make it. In the sense, they are able to make good money. She says, often talentless people make it. In the sense, they are able to make good money, sometimes in the millions and billions even, keep getting work in the mainstream and keep doing what they want to do. However, I think even being talentless is a talent in itself, as not everyone can be good at it. Would you mind if that ever happened to you? That is, if you became famous for nothing, would you mind that, or would you take it in stride and make your money?
Who would mind that? That's ridiculous. We are not Mother Teresa. But Gaurav has sort of answered the question in a way, saying it takes all types. So I think that part is fair enough. But
I just like to say something here that, you know, we think that, again, you know, saying that people are talentless is a very harsh statement. Yeah, you know, true. They might not be talented in the metric that you are evaluating them on. But for all you know, they have qualities of being persistent, maybe, you know, they have other qualities because of which they've got some work or fame or success, right? And I think a lot of people who don't have that tend to get really angry on those people. And I feel instead of that, it's best to see what worked for this guy. What did he do? You know, and like Harsha Bogle once said, it's not about talent, it's about attitude. Maybe their attitude was positive and right? So I think that it's harsh to say that there are talentless people and stuff like that. I think, yeah.
Yeah. Also, see, Sarthak is obviously got a brilliant voice. I mean, you're a, you know, authentic, sincere musician with talent. But there might be guys who, like you said, they're better on not better, but they have the stage capability.
They are doing something, right?
Flamboyant. So, yeah, correct. Yeah.
If they are famous, they are doing something, right? Correct. If it's not music, then something else. They are doing it, right? Plus, there's another thing in music that as much as talented you are, when you listen to music, you don't judge it by how talented this person is. You can either like it or you can dislike it, correct? And even that is not an option for you because you don't get to decide what you like or what you don't like. So even people who are talentless, if they are sounding good to you, they are good musicians. So this thing, like,
profound thought,
misunderstood fact that only talented musicians are really good musicians. No, it's not like that. Maybe someone who is not having talent, but they are doing something, right? They can figure it out and they can make it.
You know, I'm sorry we're stretching your time a little bit, but you're really right because, you know, someone like Anu Malik, for example, who, you know, I'm a huge fan. I'll tell you one thing, whatever people say, they may have been in the second half of his career, this and that happening, but their sheer talent of the man is immense. You can't deny that. People should also remember that, dude, the guys have talent and then, okay, some things because of taking on too much work, you know what we're talking about, but the talent is there. you cannot deny the talent. And the problem is when we start denying it. But when you guys perform and then somebody performs next to you, just the sheer voice quality, let's say, is not up to the mark compared to you. And then people judge only on that criteria. But you're right, as entertainers, it's subjective because there's, you know, Kim Kardashian would not be famous because nobody knows what she can do. Any comments? There's one body part which is outstanding, no doubt about that. I'm not one to judge and make these comments on podcast, but yeah. But
the face, she has a very nice face. Yeah.
But you know, you can criticize her as much as you want. She's one of the richest people in the world, and that's the way it is. Finish, matters closed. Yeah. I am going to be Kim Kardashian one day. That's my role model. Okay, guys, thank you so much. Hope you have a great Christmas and New Year. New Year more especially because this Kabus comes out next week. That's Sarthak and Gaurav. And of course, it's called Songfest India. If you're a young talent and you want to be the next great musician, you find yourself on Songfest India and see where you go from there. All right. Bye, guys. Have a good one.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Okay.